Full summer in the dear, lovely Berkshire Hills. Mossy and green and abundant, with that flinty New England resolve to weather the test of the winter to come. It's a time for music. Tanglewood is here, the summer home of the Boston Symphony. That's what brought me here in the beginning. It was a place to play. A yearly stop on the summer tour for me and my band. The last time I toured solo was in the late 70s. That's how I started out, just the guitar and a handful of songs. As time went by, I added other musicians because it's great playing in a big band. But from time to time, it's good to go back to the well. It's good to get back to basics and to present the songs in their original form. So it's been in my mind for a while to work small again. The Colonial Theater in my hometown of Pittsfield, Massachusetts, just managed to escape the wrecking ball. People have invested time, money, and themselves resurrecting the old girl. And along the way, they have found a new sense of belonging, a sense of place, a place called home. When we were given the chance to film and record this one-man band thing, I knew at once that the Colonial would be the right place. If you travel for a living and you do it long enough, you can get so good at it that you never really have a home. I've lived and worked in New York, Los Angeles, London and Paris, Sydney and Rio. Kim has traveled the world too, but the Berkshires are our home at last. And somehow, the Colonial Theater, that plucky survivor, is at the heart of the place.
Thank you.
So much.
All right, yes. Yankees suck, yeah. It's a cheap way to start any performance, that's for sure. I don't mean that, no.
Well, there's something in the way she moves, looks my way or calls my name, that seems to leave this troubled world behind. And if I'm feeling down and blue, troubled by some foolish game, she always seems to make me change my mind. I feel fine anytime that she's around me now. She's around me now almost all the time. If I'm well, you can tell that she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time, and I feel fine. Every now and then, the things I lean on, they lose their meaning, and I find myself careening in places where I should never let me go. No. has the power to go where no one else can find me, and to silently remind me of the happiness and good times that I know. Well, I guess I just got to know them. It isn't what she's got to say, how she thinks or where she's been. To me, the words are nice the way they sound. I like to hear them best that way. Doesn't much matter what they mean. She says them mostly just to calm me down. I feel fine anytime that she's around me now. She's around me now. I guess just about all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell that she's been with me now. She's been with me now quite a long, long time. Yes, and I feel fine.
Show you a picture of taken around the same time that song was written, 1965. This is a picture of me and Phoebe Sheldon about that time. It wasn't the first song I wrote, but it's the first presentable song. The ones that were before that were pretty awful. Songwriting is my joy and a great thrill. And a source of deep frustration, and it'll drive you crazy. But it's a mysterious thing, and something that's out of my control. Often it takes a long time before I understand what a song is really about. It this next song, actually I'm still not sure. I wrote it years ago, and I'm still not sure what it's about. That last song, I didn't realize it at the time, 25, 30 years ago, but I actually wrote it for my wife, Kim. So. this next song begins, "We were ring around the rosy children, they were circles around the sun, never give up, never slow down, never grow old, and never die young."
We ring around the rosy children, they were circles around the sun, never give up, never slow down, never grow old, never ever die young. Synchronized with the rising moon, even with the evening star, they were true love written in stone. They were never alone, they were never that far. Close our eyes to cut up our losses into doable doses, rationing our tears and sighs. You could see them on the street on a Saturday night. Everyone used to run them down. They're a little too sweet, they're a little too tight. They're not enough tough for this tough town. Couldn't touch him with a 10-foot pole. No, it didn't seem to rattle at all. They were fused together, body and soul. Not much more with their backs up against the wall.
Never die young. Always good advice, I guess. Too late for me, but anyway, in any event. Here's a picture of the Frozen Man. I'll sing a song for you now called The Frozen Man. The way he appeared in his picture in the National Geographic. It's actually surprising how little I know about the Frozen Man, given the fact that I sing this song about him. Because I didn't really read the text in the National Geographic. I looked at the pictures and read the little captions. But I got the gist of it, you know, enough to write a song and sing it for the rest of my life. I know that he was part of a polar expedition that was attempting to find a sea route from the Atlantic to the Pacific Oceans by sailing over Canada and over Alaska, which turned out to be a terrible idea, a disastrous idea. And I know that he had been in his grave, in the shallow grave that was hacked into the permafrost for him, for about 100 years when they finally found him. Whereas you or I would never disturb a hallowed resting place, these were scientists and photographers, and they didn't hesitate. Put a crowbar, or the archaeological equivalent of a crowbar, under the lip of his coffin, and just popped him right out of the ice like an ice cube out of one of those flexible ice cube trays. I see him sliding. Oh, there he goes! Stop the Frozen Man, and they stood him up. He stood up real good, and he did, and they took his picture repeatedly, which just goes to show you that even if you die before the invention of photography, you're still not safe. But anyway, their ship was caught in the ice, trapped in the pack ice, and this is an artist's rendition. Actually, looks cozy to me. Looks kind of so they're under, you know, snug under the tarpaulin there, smoking tobacco and trading ripping yarns of the sea or something like that. The old timers saying this is nothing, you know. You young people don't know hardship. This is nothing. They all died, of course. Pretty terrible thing. But, you know, it was 100 years ago, and I've gotten over it. It's time to move on. Anyway, sometime after I released the song, someone sent me this newspaper, so I wasn't the only person to think of reanimating the frozen man. And as you can see, this is the news of the world. This is, you know, pretty much a bastion of journalistic excellence and truth in reporting. News of the world. Anyway, the song's not as long as the introduction. It's grown. Here's a picture of some snow. Get us in the mood. Some trackless frozen wastes. Say goodbye to them, I guess. God have mercy on the frozen man.
Extreme old age.
I say when I die, make sure I'm gone. Don't leave them nothing to work on. You can raise your arm, you can wiggle your hand, unlike myself. So you can wave goodbye to the frozen land. I know what it means to freeze to death, lose a little life with every breath. Say goodbye to life on earth, come around again. Lord have mercy, I'm the frozen man. God have mercy on the
That's sort of a case in point. I thought that song, when I wrote it, I thought it was about the frozen man, the frozen dude at the beginning of the... I showed you the slide over there. But actually, over time, I've come to realize that it's just another song about my dad. There's a picture of my dad taken in 1955 in the South Pole, actually. He was a bit of a polar explorer himself. That's actually the family story, basically, is that my dad met my mom in Boston, had five kids, moved us all down to North Carolina, and immediately joined the Navy and went to the South Pole for 2 years. So that's it, really. Here's a picture of my mom taken around the same time, thinking about murder. About murder. Thinking about her home in New England, so far away, and her husband at the bottom of the earth there. Here's a picture of them both together I got for you. Happier days. Next song actually is a song about love, about true love, in fact, and about the sort of transformational power of true love. This is a true story called "I Was a Mean Old Man."
On my own, how could I have known? Imagine my surprise. Just a fool from a tree full of fools who can't believe his eyes. Imagine my surprise. 'Cause I was a mean old man. I was an ornery cuss. I was a dismal dad. I made an awful fuss. Ever since my life began, man, it was ever thus. I was a nasty tyke who was hard to like. I had to misbehave. I did things in reverse. Refused to wash or shave. I was horrid to my nurse. I got back what I gave, which only made me worse. I had to have my way, which was bleak and gray. Oh dear, living in here, 100 years of rain, such a drag. This riches to rags, and just myself to blame. The dirty, low-down shame of it. Dirty, low-down shame. Clever you, walking me through, happy to lead the blind, all in the nick of time. Who gets a second chance? Who gets to have some fun? Who gets to learn to dance before his race is run? Who gets to shed his skin? Who comes up born again? Who was a mean old man till you turned him into a golden retriever? Puppy doll. Who was a mean old man?
Thank you. Thank you very much. This seems like a good time to take a couple of moments to introduce the band. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, if you will, the multi-talented Mr. Larry Goldings. Larry Goldings.
Feel it. walking on country road. Sail on home to Jesus, won't you, good girls and boys? I'm born in pieces, you can have my choice. Cause I can see a heavenly band full of angels coming just to set me free. No, I don't know nothing about why or when. Tell you that it's found with me just because I could feel it. Walking on country road, reckon my feet know where they want me to go. Walking on a country road, walking on a dirt road. Take to the highway, won't you lend me your name? Your way, my way, so loving one and the same thing tonight. My mama don't understand it. She wants to know where the boy's been. After this song, kind of not so bold. Walk on out the road again, but you know I can feel.
When we started putting this evening together about a year and a half ago, we decided to try to avoid the sort of modern gimmicks and the available sort of digital signal processors and flangers and phasers and ring modulators and all kinds of, and for sure we weren't going to use any drum machine that was out. No drum machine, absolutely out of the question. Right out from the top. Of course, we caved in almost immediately, and the song was trash.
Show, so it's a same game wherever you go.
Thanks. You were brave to dance.
Yes.
That's right. Oh, yeah. Well, you know, those high school woodworking classes. That was made by a friend of mine who works down in Great Barrington named Gordon Fairfield, made that machine. Technologies of centuries gone by. This next song has a bit of a gimmick as well. It's a traveling song, and after a while, that's pretty much what you get. It's traveling songs. But, this is a song that's best performed with a choir, a large choir. Actually, as luck has it, my lovely wife Kim. Sometimes works with the Tanglewood Festival Chorus, which is fantastic, local and very vocal group, and we managed to get 16 of their number with sort of impaired judgment to come up to the barn where Larry and I were rehearsing, and we recorded them and shot them, filmed them, you know. So if you see adult human figures who appear over my left shoulder as if by magic, it's just a motion picture. Don't get alarmed. It's a thing. This is My Traveling Star. Watch my back and light my way.
My traveling star, my traveling
watch
star.
Watch over all those born St. Christopher's Day.
Old road dog, young runaway.
They hunger for home, but they never stay.
They wait by the door, they stand and they stare.
They're already out of there.
They're already out of there.
My daddy used to ride the rails, they say.
So they say, so they say.
Soft as smoke and as tough as nails, my daddy.
Rock star.
like going to jail.
The sheets and the blankets and babies and all, you never did come back home.
Never that I recall.
Never mind the wind, never mind the rain, never mind the road leading home again, never asking why, never knowing when. Every now and then, there he goes again.
She had a cat and a dog named Blue. Big old stove and a fireplace too.
Old road dog, young runaway.
She told me she loved me like it was true.
I knew I should stay, I knew I would go.
Run away, boy.
Run before the wind, run before the rain, over yonder hill, just around the bend, never asking why, never knowing when. Every now and then, there you go again.
Tie me up and hold me down.
Oh, my traveling song.
Carry my feet down in the ground. Lost and found,
and let me believe this is where I belong.
Shame on me for sure. Sing me one more highway song.
Traveling Star. That was members of the Tanglewood Festival Chorus. I want to show you a picture of a nightclub in Los Angeles called the Troubadour on the corner of Santa Monica and Doheny. Actually, it's kind. That's to call it a nightclub is to stretch it. It's a dive and a joint and a hole in the wall, and it just seems to thrive on neglect. It continues year after year, and I played there repeatedly, evidently, in the early 70s. That picture was not taken in the early 70s. The cars are wrong, and the people would they'd have their costumes on, you know. And the purple haze would be all in their brains. The Troubadour. And when I played there, the three times I played there, I shared the bill with Carole King. Here's a picture of Carole. That's her heart. And she and I shared a band. This is what people looked like in those days. This is what people look like when they don't have access to mirrors. And basically, they have to go on other people's say-so. How do I look? You look fine. How do I look? You look fine. Let's go. Anyway, that right next to Carole there, the one that looks like the Smith Brothers cough drop box, is a legendary bass player named Leland Sklar. Lee Sklar. my old partner Lee, and my old best friend up above Carol there, Danny Kortzmore, Cooch, named Cooch. Anyway, the one next to him who looks like Joni Mitchell with a mustache is me. And I seem to have forgotten to eat again. It's happened a lot. Anyway, Carol had written this great song, really a perfect pop song, I thought. And Carol, in an amazing, what actually turned out to be a typically generous gesture, insisted that I take the first crack at this tune and record it first. She was in the studio recording herself, but she let go to what, to my mind, was the perfect song. I didn't realize at the time that I'd be singing it every single night for the rest of my life. But and glad too really, because it's a great song to be known for. So anyway, I asked Joni Mitchell if she would sing some harmonies with me on it, and at the time she was my, today you'd say she was my bitch. Seems rude when you just say it like that. I was her bitch too, you know, so it was, maybe that helps, co-bitch kind of thing. Anyway, so you've got your Joni Mitchell and your James Taylor and your Carole King, and you've got a friend. When you're down in trouble and you need some love and care, and nothing, oh, nothing is going right, just close your eyes and think of me. Yes, and soon I will be there to brighten up, oh, even your darkest night. You just call out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. It's winter, spring, summer, or fall. All you've gotta do is call on me, and I will be there, yeah, yes, I'll be there. You've got a friend. If the sky high above you should grow dark and full of clouds, and that old cold north wind should begin to blow, just keep your poor head together now. Call my name out loud, you know. Pretty soon I'll be knocking on your door. You just call out my name, you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. It's winter, spring, summer, or fall. Really, all you gotta do is call. And I'll be there, you know, I'll be there. Oh, ain't it good to know you've got a friend when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you, yes, and desert you. Well, they'll take your soul if you let them. But don't you let them. You just call out.
of my name. And you know wherever I am, I'll come running like as fast as I can to see you again. Oh yeah, so don't you know about that winter, spring, summer or fall? I'll be there. You got a friend. You got a friend. Ain't it good to know that you've got a friend? Walking and talking and everything, friend. Well, I said everybody here tonight, it's feeling that I have some time, but to take some consolation. One thing, oh yeah, ain't good to know. Yeah, 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 yeah. You got a friend.
It's nice to, well, it's dangerous to play at home, but but it's nice, you know. It's the lovely Berkshires, you know, the best place on the earth. I've done extensive research, and I find that to be true, the best place there is.
Most beautiful place on earth.
It is. Okay, we'll have to take that out, though, to edit that out, because, you know, we wouldn't want to show any favorites. I have to re-record You Got a Friend with all the rest of the cities in it, too. You know. So it's painstaking, you know, but it pays off. Anyway, well, we're going to take a brief break. I'm not exactly sure why. Larry and I will go backstage and we'll think about what we've done. And, you know, we'll probably bong a few lewds and then come back and sing the second set, which is, you know, second set, perfectly adequate in many ways. It's written on some sort of the material we make set lists on has changed, and this is like a roofing material of some sort. It's flexible but durable, like I like my women, ladies and gentlemen. See, electric guitar, a vast improvement over the gas and steam guitars that preceded it. Development. The old jokes are best, don't you think? Sure they are.
Well, if I'm a steamroller for you, baby, I'd like to roll out all over you. Yes, and I'm a demon roller for you, baby. I'd like to roll on and over you. And now, baby, I'd like to index this old rhythm, rock and roll, maybe shoot you full of rhythm, ain't it blue tonight? Hey, now. Well, I'm a demon mitten for you, baby, a churning under that burning funk. I said, hey, Bruce and Joe, and Jay, the thing that got you, babe, you got to drop that thing.
trying to come back home to me, baby. Trying to learn in the burning funk. Demolition derby bomber, Captain Conker, steaming junk. Bomb for you, baby. I'm guaranteed it doesn't blow your mind. Listen, I'm a love bomb for you, baby. I'm guaranteed it didn't blow your mind. If I can't, but if I can't, and if I can't have your loving, there won't be nothing ever left behind. Oh, no, 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 yeah, no, yeah, yeah, no, 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 yeah. But I never did see, and I never did see in the far distant future someday lose. Ain't seen a lose, baby. Yeah. Somebody got to help me to lose. Got to help me lose. Yeah. Yeah.
Help me to lose my steamroller, yeah. Help me to lose my steamroller, darling. Lose my steamroller, baby, yeah.
I'm gonna lose my roofer, super roofer, safer sofa, now, my baby.
Yeah.
Generic sort of water for television. Television water, I think. Wouldn't like to single anybody out, you know. Huh? Yeah, that's right, yeah. Lake Pontusic.